So in this lecture we will see that how to create a class or the class specification. So the class can be created in the following way. It has a keyword class followed by a valid class name. Okay. Then comes the starting curly brace. In the starting curly braces, okay, below this we will just mention the data members. Okay, so these are the data variable 1, okay, data variable 2, and so on. Next step is, okay, we have just divided this class into two. The first portion is that contains the data variables, and the second portion is that contains the member functions. So the member functions will be contained inside, okay, a specifier that is known as public. So we have to mention a specifier. So this public is, it is a specifier, it is also known as an access specifier. Okay, this is access specifier. Okay. So all the member functions of a particular class must be, okay, in this public specifier. Okay, so we are just, okay, we are just dealing with public. Okay, so there are different types of specifiers, but here our main target is that we will just see that how this public specifier works. So public means that it is open to all. Okay, anyone can access this, the contents that are inside this public specifiers. Okay, so here I'll just, okay, create member function 1. Okay, again it can have member function 2 and so on. So here we are just saying the function as a member function. Okay, why we are saying member function? Because this function is a member of this particular class. Okay, so we can, okay, also define this member function inside the same class, okay, or we can define it outside the class. Okay, so here I have just declared it. Okay, and the next step is we will just complete the class, okay, followed by a semicolon. So this semicolon is must. Okay, if we won't provide this semicolon, okay, so it will result in an error. Okay, so now we will just, okay, we will just see that what these, okay, these constructs are, okay, and what these constructs, okay, tell. So this class, it means that this is a keyword. Okay, so this is a keyword. So when we use a class keyword, so it tells, okay, a compiler will, okay, will just, it will be notified to the compiler that a user has created its own data type. Okay, so the class that we are creating, okay, this class name, so this class is, you can say it is a user defined data type. Okay, it is a user defined data type, or you can say it is an abstract data type. Okay, because a user is creating its own data type. Okay, the variables, now we are saying the name of the variable is data variable. Okay, we are more focusing on the word data because this data, okay, the main object of object oriented programming is to make this data secure. Okay, so that's why this data is being kept in a portion that is hidden. Okay, that is hidden from the outside world, and this particular portion, this is by default private. Okay, this is by default a private mode. We can also specify, okay, explicitly private, and after that we'll put a colon and we will specify, we'll just declare these data variables inside this, or by default, okay, the class contains all the data variables inside a private access specifier. Okay, so there is no need to mention the private keyword. Why we are keeping this inside the private? Because the main motto is to make this data, okay, hidden from the outside world. Okay, so we are providing data security or data hiding. Okay, so this is, you can say, we are providing data hiding. So it is very important property, okay, of object oriented programming. Now next is public. So this is also a specifier. Public means all the member functions that we are declaring inside this public specifier, it will be accessible outside the class. Okay, any function can access it. Okay, it can be accessed directly through main. Okay, so in this way we can just create a specification for a class. Now the second important thing, this is not complete in itself. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to also create an object, because without object, okay, the class is, okay, you can say class is not completed. So now how to create an object? So basically we will create an object by, okay, by providing a class name. Okay, for example, if this is a class name, a valid class name, okay, so this class name followed by any variable. Okay, any variable. So this variable is now an object. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll just read it as, this variable is of type class. Okay, so when we have just created, okay, in your earlier lectures, if we just write this statement int x, okay, or int a, so it means that this a is a variable of type integer. Okay, in a same way, this variable, okay, that we are creating is of type class. Okay, so this class is an abstract data type, or this is a user defined data type. So we have to mention it, okay, because if we won't mention this class name, so it will be an ambiguity for the compiler, because compiler won't understand that what you have created. Okay, for compiler, okay, because it is not predefined to the compiler. We are creating our own data type, so we have to tell to the compiler that yes, for this data type, okay, we have created this particular variable that is known as an object. So we can also say that this particular object is also known as, okay, so this object is also known as, it is also known as instance of a class. Okay, instance of a class. Okay, so it is also an instance. Okay, so when we are creating a class, so we are also, okay, we are also creating, okay, we are also specifying the attributes and the behavior or the functionalities, so that can be accessed with some instance, okay, with some variable that is a part of that particular class. Okay, so if we want to access a particular variable, so we can access the particular variable with the help of object name, okay, followed by a dot operator, followed by the name of the member function. Okay, because we can't access, okay, we can't access the data variables directly. Okay, so to access the data members, okay, there is a member function that is a member of its class to which the data members, okay, or the member functions belong, because it belongs to the same group. Okay, that's why it can access its own data members, and it can access the data members with the help of this object. Okay, so we can say that these member functions work as, okay, a verb. Okay, so a verb can do a certain task on a particular noun. So this object is a noun, okay, on which we are, this is a noun on which we are, okay, invoking the necessary details or the necessary implementation task that we are invoking. Okay, so it can be done with the help of this particular way. Okay, so we'll just see an example. Okay, we'll just see an example in the subsequent lecture, that how we will create a class and how we will access this particular class with the help of an object. Thanks.